बघ आता राहिलेला रिमेनिंग पार्ट आपण याच्या ह्या लेक्चर मध्ये पाहणार आहोत. रीड द एक्सप्रेशन ओल्ड डिलिशियस बर्डन्स. बर्डन कंटेन कॅन नॉट सॉरी कॅन नॉट बी डिलिशियस. द पोएट हॅज यूज दिस कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ वर्ड टू एक्सप्रेस दॅट ही हॅज मेनी स्वीट मेमरीज ऑफ द पीपल अँड प्लेसेस यू वूड लाईक टू रिमेंबर. यू वूड लाईक टू रिमेंबर फॉर एवर. द पोएट हॅज यूज द सीमिंगली कॉन्ट्राडिक्टरी एक्सप्रेशन टू कन्व्हे द मीनिंग दॅट हिज हार्ट इज फुल ऑफ स्वीट मेमरीज ऑफ गुड अँड काइंड पीपल दो ही वॉन्ट टू बी फ्री फ्रॉम एनी टाइप ऑफ अटॅचमेंट. He wants to cherish these sweet memories in his heart forever. So describes your journey would be sufficient for you, as although expression contained opposite ideas makes it seem as absurd, unlikely, so although it may be true, and this is collected as a paradox. काय कलेक्ट केलेलं आहे ऍज अ पॅराडॉक्स, म्हणजे कशा प्रकारे विरोधाभास दाखवलेला आहे. सो स्टील हिअर आय कॅरी माय ऑल डिलिशियस बर्डन्स इज द लाईन दॅट इज हॅव्हिंग अ पॅराडॉक्स. सो डिलिशियस अँड बर्डन्स, समथिंग डिलिशियस इज प्लीजंट, वेअर ॲज बर्डन रिमाइंड अस समथिंग डिफिकल्ट अँड अनप्लीजंट. समथिंग difficult and unpleasant, but the poet wants to convey that his sweet memories are difficult to leave behind. They pull us back from going away, but still he will go, but he will carry these precious memories and still carry on his life journey. So paradox is called as a poetic device. PARADOX. Paradox manje ka? As a poetic device. So ek poetic device manun ahe. So which is defined as लॉजिक, म्हणजे एक कलंकार आहे विरोधाभास अलंकार, विच इज डिफाइंड ॲज लॉजिकल स्टेटमेंट कॉन्ट्राडिक्टिंग इट सेल्फ. इट कॅन अल्सो बी सेड बी सेंटेन्स दॅट इज अपोज टू कॉमन सेन्स, बट इट कॅन बी ट्रू ॲज अ ट्रू. सो पॅराडॉक्स इज अ पोएटिक डिवाइस विच इज डिफाइंड ॲज अ लॉजिकल स्टेटमेंट कॉन्ट्राडिक्टिंग इट सेल्फ. इट अल्सो कॅन बी said to a sentence that is opposed to the common sense, but it can be true. Next, second, B. The road in the poem does not mean only the road to travel. The poet wants to suggest the road of life. Explain the metaphor with the help of the poem. The road in the poem does not mean only the road to travel. The poet wants to suggest the road of life. Explain the metaphor with the help of this life or the poem. आता मेटाफर जो आहे तो सुद्धा पोएटिक डिवाइस आहे, अलंकार आहे. इन अ जर्नी we may go on, we plan on the mode of travel and hope to have an enjoyable trip. We want to admire the scenes passing by. We may meet new people. Sometimes we may come
come across some difficulties. Some difficulties yet we complete the trip and return home to our normal as a routine. Normal routine. म्हणजे आपण नॉर्मल रुटीनच्या वेळेस कशा बघा बघा कशा प्रकारे याच्यामध्ये सांगितलेलं आहे असं नॉर्मल रुटीन. फॉर अ ट्रीप वी मेक ट्रॅव्हल प्लॅन डिसाइड द डेस्टिनेशन अँड सो ऑन. बट लाईफ इट सेल्फ इज अ लॉंग जर्नी. पण जीवनच काय आहे स्वतःच एक प्रवास आहे. फक्त आपण जहाजाने विमानाने ऑन द रेल्वे ऑन फॉर एक्झाम्पल रेल्वे और वॉटरवेज एअरवेज फक्त ह्या मार्गाने गेलं म्हणजे आपला प्रवास घडतो का? नाही. सो लाईफ इट सेल्फ इज अ जर्नी. सो फॉर अ ट्रीप बट लाईफ इट सेल्फ इज अ लॉंग जर्नी. इन अवर लाईफ वी हॅव फॅमिली अँड फ्रेंड्स. इन अवर लाईफ वी हॅव फॅमिली अवर फ्रेंड्स. वी डोंट नो व्हॉट विल हॅपन इन फ्युचर. आपल्याला आपल्या फ्युचरमध्ये भविष्यामध्ये आपल्यासोबत काय घडेल याची आपण कल्पना करू शकतो का? नाही. विल नॉट शुअर अबाउट युअर फ्युचर. सो वी डोंट नो व्हॉट विल हॅपन इन अवर फ्युचर. वी रिमेंबर प्लीझंट ॲज वेल ॲज सॅड सिच्युएशन ऑफ द पास्ट. वी रिमेंबर प्लीझंट ॲज वेल ॲज सॅड सिच्युएशन ऑफ द पास्ट. सो वी वर्क हार्ड फाइंड सक्सेस. We work hard, find success, face failure and attain glory, defeat. So life goes on. In both a trip or in life, the attitude is important. In both a trip or in life, the attitude is important in how we make the journey. One must go ahead with a positive and flexible mindset. So unexpected situations will come up. We may have pleasant as well as unpleasant situation. We may have pleasant as well as unpleasant situation. But if we have self-belief, any difficulties can be faced. One must just be strong. One must just be as a strong. So the poem also tells us we have memories, we are held back by attachment, but we can carry the beautiful past as happy memories. We should always go forward in the journey of our life. Next, third, free verse, okay? Free verse means what? F-R-E-E, free verse, V-E-R-S, free verse आहे. तो एक poetic devices भाग आहे, that is free word. आता free म्हणजे बंधनातून मुक्त होणं ते वेगळं, पण याच्यामध्ये बघा free verse. Free verse is a poetry that does not rhyme or have a regular rhythm. बघा फ्री वर्स इज पोएट्री दॅट डज नॉट राईम. त्याच्यामध्ये यमक जुळणारे शब्द असणार आहे का? नाही. त्याला फ्री वर्स म्हणलं जातं. और राईम टू हॅव रेग्युलर रिदम. द फीचर्स ऑफ फ्री वर्स आर, आता कुठले कुठले फीचर्स आहेत बघा. इट इज अ लिटररी डिवाइस दॅट इज फ्री फ्रॉम लिमिटेशन ऑफ रेग्युलर मीटर और रिदम. Free from limitation of regular meter or rhythm, does not rhyme with fixed forms, and still it provides an artistic expression. In this way, the poet can give his own shape to poem. The poet can give his own shape to poem as he desires, and can use various poetic devices to create effect he considers suitable for the piece. He considers suitable for the piece. As free verse gives greater freedom for choosing words conveying They are meaning to readers. It is free from artificiality of typical poetic expression. So this technique is commonly used in modern poetry. Okay? This technique is commonly used in modern poetry. Kudli technique as a free verse. Free verse manje kay hai? Is a poetry that does not have a rhythm, have regular rhythm. So features आपण पाहिलेले आहे, इट इज लिटररी डिव्हाइस ऑर इट इज फ्री फ्रॉम लिमिटेशन ऑफ रेग्युलर मीटर रिदम. सो डज नॉट राईम विथ फिक्स्ड फॉर्म्स अँड टील इट प्रोव्हाइड्स अँड आर्टिस्टिक एक्सप्रेशन. सो इन दिस वे वी कॉल्ड ॲज अ रेग्युलर पोएटिक डिव्हाइस इफ इट वी कन्सिडर ॲज सुटेबल फॉर द प्रिसेज. सो वी ॲज फ्री वर्ड्स गिव्ज ग्रेटर फ्रीडम for choosing words, conveying their meaning for readers, and it is free from artificiality. म्हणजे आर्टिफिशियलिटी पासून ते काय असतं, फ्री असतो. का असतो आर्टिफिशियल? कशामध्ये असतो की तुमच्या पोएम्समध्ये रिदम दिलेला असतो का? लेखकाला त्या कविता जी असते सजवायची असते, त्यामुळं कॉल्ड ॲज आर्टिफिशियल. रिमेंबर, ऑल्दो फ्री वर्स रिक्वायर्स नो मीटर राईम or other traditional poetic technique, it is the uses of internal pattern of sounds, the choice of extract words and their chosen places are the factors which attributes the free verse its lyrical or rhythmic beauty. So free verse is different from ब्लँक वर्स. फ्री वर्स आहे डिफरंट आहे कशापासून? ॲज अ ब्लँक वर्स पासून डिफरंट आहे. विच इसेन्शियली हॅज टू ऑकर इन अँबिक पेंट्रामीटर. ब्लँक वर्स इज अ पोएट्री विथ रिटन विथ रेग्युलर मेट्रिकल पॉट अँड राईम लाईन्स. इट इज डिस्क्राइब्ड ॲज द कॉमन मोस्ट कॉमन फॉर्म ऑफ इंग्लिश पोएट्री विच हॅज बीन influential since the 16th century. There are certain words that are repeated in there are certain words that are repeated in the poem. For example, no more, line 7. Okay, no more, line 7. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, no more, that is repeated. Then we see, find out the similar expression, explain the effect they have created in the poem. Ada kutla apan shodhu shakto? For example, open road, line 1st and 7 indicate that the path in the life is open wide for the poet person to make any choice he wants. The opportunities are unlimited. Before me, the poet is looking for at the road. Road. Before me, henceforth, good fortune, I know, line 11 and 12. I carry line 12 and 13 and they are line 10 emphasizes as entirety. Okay, maje asha lines ja ahet ta repeated zalela ahet. Next apan pahu shakto the use of personal pronoun I is evident and prominent in this poem and give reason. Tela kay dyaycha ahe? Karan dyaycha ahe. The repetition of the pronoun I occurs 15 times in many lines of the poem. This shows us how fully in charge of the poet and is of his life, his destiny, his actions, his decisions and the consequences. The repeated use of I shows that he is confident of himself and is able to take his life forward independent of other support. He is going to stop complaining, criticizing. He will approach
the future on his own strength, so ready to use opportunity that he came across. The poet is quite as sufficient. He does not need either luck or influential friends to help his attempts. He seemed assured of his own capability. Next, FIU, first. With the help of the following points, write a poetic appreciation of the poem. With the help of the following point, write a poetic appreciation of the poem. So, Song of the Open Road. For example, Song of the Open Road. About the poem, the poet and the title, the theme, poetic style, language, poetic device used in the poem, special features, message, values, morals in the poem, your opinion about the poem. Your opinion about the poem. So, about the poem and the poet, about the title. For example, The Song of the Open Road is written by American poet Walt Whitman. And Walt Whitman is about optimism, energy, confidence. The world offers opportunities to anyone who wants to use them. Walt Whitman's works were powerful influence on others writer. Next, the theme. Okay, the poet himself struggled as a child of friends. The poet himself struggled as a child of friends. He dropped out of school. He dropped out of school. He worked as a labor assistant, printer's assistant. And he dropped out of school to take up some jobs to help the family income. He worked as a lawyer's assistant, printer's assistant, and as a teacher and journalist. He helped look forward after the wounded in the American Civil War. The poem says, Open Road, it is about freedom, and the poet wants to go out from restriction and comforts. Restrictions and comforts. The poet wants to be self-reliant. He is confident. The poem is in free verse, and there are many poetic devices, but no meter or rhyme. We immediately notice repetition. There is also transport repeated, and the poem is a dramatic monologue. The poem inspires us to explore the world and using our abilities, comforts, complaints, criticism, and fate are not excuses for one's inaction. So a poem in the form of speech, what is means? Dramatic monologue. आता dramatic monologue म्हणजे काय? तर a poem in the form of speech or narrative by imaginary person in which the speaker reveals aspects of their character. So, the song of the open road is in the form of a dramatic monologue. I hope you have understood very well. Thank you very much.